Welcome, welcome, welcome. My name is Al Almasabi, and I work at Elevate Energy. On behalf of all of the elevators, I want to acknowledge every viewer for being a huge part of our anniversary. I encourage everyone to participate by clicking on the chat button and typing a question, comment, and compliment into the chat box, or text to give to show your support. We'll interact with you during the show. I am pleased to introduce our host for the next hour. He's a senior producer at WBEZ, working there for the last 20 years. You might have heard his work on programs such as Worldview with Jerome McDonald and Reset with Jen White. Please put your hands together, snap, clap, or put your hands in the air for Steve Bynum.
Wow, thanks, Al. And it's so great to be here with you to reflect on Elevate Energy's 20 and 2020. Elevate Energy has been doing its best for the last 20 years, giving people the tools they need to make informed energy choices and building a vibrant and sustainable world. They do this while focusing on their core values of community partnerships, equity, and collaboration. And I urge you to work with them toward the same goal. Just imagine how affirming a world that would make. Today, we'll introduce you to some of the passionate people who work at Elevate and are dedicated to equitably transforming our environmental legacy in homes, communities, cities, and the world. You'll also meet some of our community partners. Most importantly, we're here to salute 8 inspiring climate change makers whose great work is affirmed on a daily basis. Today, we'll share the terrific work of Elevate's past. What was then, what we're working on now, and roll out our future focus, what lies ahead. It's safe to say that it's been a deeply challenging time. However, it's also a time of considerable hope, and you can be a part of that change when you support this outstanding organization. You can text to give, see how in the chat. To better understand Elevate and the world of CEO and Evans, here's a clip that's better than words.
I'm Ann Evans, and I'm well aware of my generation's impact on the planet. We believe that our solutions to the climate crisis address racial and wealth inequities.
I'm Natalia Evans, and the impact of climate change is real and urgent for my generation and for those who follow.
We are your future, and our future depends on a healthy planet.
We are your future, and our future depends on a healthy planet.
We will know we are successful when the most underserved communities who have been left out or left behind are leading the way. By 2030, we will reduce greenhouse gas necessary for climate equity, racial and economic justice, and opportunity for all.
Take action now. Toma acción ya.
Take action now. We got you, world. We got you.
I have no problem saying that where we adults have failed, young people are next in line to lead. And they needn't look further than Elevate's Ann Evans for illumination. For decades, this thought leader has been at the forefront of transforming lives by improving global health, energy efficiency, environmental justice, and now tackling climate change. As Ann has said, a safe and healthy home also provides a solid foundation for education, employment, and a social life. Housing solutions are life solutions. Ann and Elevate have been working to provide that safe and healthy home for 20 years. And now let me introduce you to our guiding force, Ann Evans.
Hi, Steve. We're so thankful that you lend your presence and deep awareness of our issues to this gathering. I'm so excited to be here with you now at this time to highlight our partners and to commemorate our shared commitment to advancing racial equity through climate change. So what does that really mean? It means that we are helping people in Black and Brown communities to save money, to get good jobs, and not only survive, but thrive. I can't tell you how grateful I am to be here with our network of friends and supporters from across the country. We look forward to this family-friendly power hour as a time to lift our spirits as we look at what is possible when we work together. Since our founding, Elevate has retrofitted over 70,000 units of affordable housing to be more energy efficient. We've opened career paths in the booming clean energy economy and created more than 800 jobs for people seeking a second chance. We want to thank our founding CEO, the amazing Kathy Tholin. It was her leadership that got us started within our parent organization, the Center for Neighborhood Technology.
Hi, I'm Kathy Tholin. At the Center for Neighborhood Technology, my colleagues Bob Lieberman, Scott Bernstein, and I founded the Community Energy Cooperative, which would later become Elevate Energy. Our very first project in the year 2000 let people trade in their old window air conditioners for new energy efficient ones in several Chicago communities. We had a three-part goal: to lower peak electricity demand, reduce power outages, and save people money. It was exciting then to develop some new approaches to community energy efficiency programs. And it's great today to celebrate Elevate's 20 years of innovation, success, and impact.
I thank Kathy for her friendship and mentorship throughout the years. We wouldn't be here without her support. So Kathy, please look for a little Elevate, environmentally friendly and sustainable gift that's coming your way soon. Thanks also to the host committee and co-chairs Ann Hallett and Margaret Odell. And to all of our sponsors and to all of you who are sharing this day with us today. You know, this is a difficult time that brings new stressors to our community seemingly every day. But through this challenge, I've also seen the beauty of people coming together to support each other. We always start with listening, and what we heard was that people need emergency assistance during this pandemic. So we were able to pivot our work to meet those needs. That included providing emergency water deliveries and over $80,000 worth of groceries to seniors. We listened to our partners in the affordable housing community, like Bickerdike, whose residents needed rental assistance due to the lost income. They sent us heartfelt thanks, and we'll share those with you later. We listened to our Black and Brown contractors who work on our upgrades. We stood by them to help them and hold their hands through the payroll protection program application process, and by providing them working capital so that they could keep paying their employees and feed their families. Knowing that extreme heat is now the norm, we installed air conditioners for our seniors who couldn't risk going to cooling centers during COVID. Over and over, we see the same zip codes and the same Black and Brown people bearing the brunt of a crisis from our policy failures. We do our part to tell that story. That's a snapshot of Elevate coming together at this time in this moment. But our team and our friends have so much more to share as we identify problems and solutions. Please enjoy this commemoration of our 20 years, our story of then, now, and next, and the people who make it all possible. Let's go back to Steve to introduce you to some people who model our solution-oriented approach and who are taking action in their communities and touching people near and far.
And thank you, Anne. You are a galvanizing force for generations of future leaders. And now let's meet the first of three change makers we're saluting today. All three work in Chicago neighborhoods to improve the quality of lives for their neighbors. They advocate through policy and outreach and other wonderful programs that build, feed, and house their neighbors. Our first change maker, Juliana Pino, is an environmental policy advocate with Little Village Environmental Justice Organization, Elvejo. She works on policy issues related to climate change and is a proponent of amending outdated laws.
We have laws preventing heat from being turned off.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
We don't have laws around air conditioning, for example.
Mm-hmm.
We don't have laws around water. Mm-hmm. There are other, like, really essential to surviving some of these extreme heat or cold events. Resources that we don't have protections for folks on the books about, because our protections exist from a time period when we didn't have to think about climate change and how extreme some of these seasons would be.
The impact of climate change affects us in ways in which we're not even aware. And if you're not aware of our next change maker, well, you should be. Anton Seals leads Grow Greater Inglewood, an organization that focuses on building equitable neighborhood food systems.
Even getting people onto the land, people who have the knowledge, who want to farm and have a farm business to grow more collards and greens or whatever, is the land ready to be accessible where you can grow on it? Who protects it? And what are you selling? You know, and should it be free?
Right.
Because then who pays for your labor? How do you survive?
Our next change maker believes that survival is based on basic humanity. Pat Abrams is formerly in leadership at Center for Neighborhood Technology. She left to become the founder and CEO of the Renaissance Collaborative. It's a social enterprise organization dedicated to helping Bronzeville residents with affordable housing options and solutions for a more humane life.
We have to place much more emphasis on the human element. And that just requires different kind of way of thinking about things. Because humans ultimately are responsible for capitalism and the bottom line. But you have to value the human beings who are doing the work. When the labor movement first started and what was going on then, I think it's getting real close to that now, where people think more about the bottom line than they do the workers who are creating that bottom line.
Thank you, Liana, Anton, and Pat. What powerful and determined people. Each of them used their voice for positive change. So much innovation and creativity that moves people to work with their community and equitably transform it. Love it. Now we're going to introduce you to more fantastic elevators. They're going to talk about energy and elevate then.
I came to Elevate in 2010. From a for-profit consulting firm. Elevate in 2010 was one of several departments driving community-oriented sustainability efforts at Center for Neighborhood Technology. It was so refreshing to be in an environment grounded in not only idea generation, but committed to idea refinement. As part of CNT, it's cheesy to say, but Elevate wasn't just a think tank, it was a do tank. Even in 2010, it wasn't just focused on energy conservation and carbon emissions reduction. I was hired as a healthy housing coordinator my first year because Elevate understood the connections between energy efficiency, housing reinvestment, and preservation in low-income households.
We had developed the Energy Smart Pricing Plan, which was an hourly energy program designed to save customers money on their residential electricity bills. And the pilot was a success, but when it came time for the program to be brought to the whole ComEd customer base, ComEd was concerned that we, as a small nonprofit, would not be able to bring it to scale. And ComEd came back to us and asked if we would like to administer it. We said yes, and we've been doing so ever since. And as of today, there are 35,000 customers on the program, and they've saved a total of $27 million.
The bridge that took Elevate from then to now was realizing that our potential didn't just stop at energy efficiency programs. We were able to take what we learned from designing and implementing those programs and apply it to new ways to help people and the planet.
I started just straight out of grad school, and we were definitely building the plane while flying. We shared a bathroom and a kitchen. We didn't have air conditioners or fridges for a while, which is funny because we were in the business of giving out Energy Star appliances. But we painted the walls ourselves when we got a new office. We barbecued together, pulled weeds, we gardened together, and we grew together. I felt a very certain way about Elevate that is still hard to compare to anywhere else I've ever worked, and maybe anywhere else I'll ever work.
The elevators have spoken, and now here's some well wishes from friends in the wide world.
Happy birthday, Elevate. I've known you pretty much your whole life. I've had the great pleasure of working with your team throughout your history, and it's always been a fun and purpose-driven adventure. Our first real collaboration was in my tenure in the Chicago Department of Environment, when natural gas prices were skyrocketing and Chicagoans were really getting hurt by uncontrolled heating bills and excuses from the gas utility. You guys stepped up and delivered innovative strategies that helped residents cut their energy use and cap out-of-control prices. In 2004, when I moved to the private sector, I still remember pointing to your example as the basis for my business plan. It was clear energy transformation was happening, and you guys were proving it could scale. You know, business plans are like a movie pitch. Just visualize it, kind of Avengers Endgame. We're going to save the world and make money doing it. You were an early client as we tried to address the burden of outdated and harmful coal-fired power plants, and a critical part of the team that we put together to take Wisconsin's well-respected energy program to the next level.
I am so happy to be able to congratulate Elevate Energy for 20 years of terrific service in promoting smarter energy use for all. An innovative project that I enjoyed working with Elevate Energy on was to explore opportunities for using landscape trees as an energy efficiency measure, particularly planting residential trees in the landscape that could provide energy savings for summertime cooling and then wintertime heating energy loads. So congratulations to Elevate Energy. It's been a joy to work with you these past many years, and I look forward to a bright future with you.
Our team has worked with Elevate Energy a number of years now, supporting their Illinois Utility Program activities. Through the coordinated efforts led by Elevate Energy, we were able to make significant impacts together, reducing energy costs for public housing facilities, income-eligible multifamily facilities, and nonprofit organizations. Together, we assessed over 250 facilities, and that projected to over 2.3 million kilowatt hours of electric savings and over 124,000 therms of natural gas savings, which contribute to the overall state of Illinois energy efficiency goals. It's been exciting to work with Elevate Energy. Congratulations on reaching 20 years, and all the best to Elevate Energy on the next 20 years.
Our next three changemakers cover the spaces of affordable housing, food equity, and climate change. The commonality for these sustainability warriors is advocating for human rights, the belief that people should live in a community they can afford, that we should all have access to healthy food where we live, and that we all should be able to breathe air that's not polluted. That's not too much to ask, is it? Susie Schlossberg grew up in Beijing, one of the most polluted cities in the world. Now she's a high school senior and a leader of Chicago Youth Alliance for Climate Action. And she's motivated in her resolve to implement change with other youth and advocate for mitigating the effects of climate change.
You see these issues that have really infiltrated schools and, you know, youth communities.
Yeah.
And no one was doing anything about them. And so that really motivated, I think, a worldwide shift towards youth activism. Mm. And I hope that that's a shift that remains. Whether that looks like activism on the ground or if it just looks like more young people getting included without them having to beg for it. You know, that's what I hope is going to happen in the future.
Another future-facing activist is Lissette Castañeda, the interim executive director of Lucha, an affordable housing enterprise in the Logan Square neighborhood. Lissette's a fierce advocate for her constituency.
Housing is a basic human right that we shouldn't have to fight for. We dream of a world where, like, it's not a fight, you know, where it's like it's basic. Like, of course you have housing, and of course it's housing you can afford, and of course you have choice, you know,
right?
Because this is the other part of it, that it's like, oh, well, there's like affordable housing all over the city. It's like, yeah, but not everybody like wants to live in that one place. That like lack of choice and that lack of autonomy to say like, I want to like live here, and having that not be available to everyone is infuriating.
You know, for a lot of Chicagoans, it's infuriating that where they live determines their access to healthy food. Our next change maker is trying to provide a workaround for that, block by block. Ramon Etc., also known as Radius, is a co-founder of Love Fridge Chicago, it's a collective of activists who believe feeding oneself shouldn't be a privilege, but rather a right. The group works to nourish communities while combating food scarcity and food waste.
Community fridge movement, where you have 24/7 access to cold storage, to food, and you're diminishing food waste because farmers or other distributors that would normally throw this food out or didn't have another place to put it can take it directly and put it into a fridge. It's for anybody, not just for, you know, it's no discrimination who eats or who leaves the food or who eats the food. They have access to this. You know, I call it like a pyramid, an energy source. You can go to it. You don't got to wait for the food pantry to be open and wait in a long line. Or you don't got to wait for the farmer's market is only over 5 hours. You have 24/7 access to eat.
I have to say this, but my hope is renewed once again. What an empowering trio, Susie, Lissette, and Ramon. They are living Elevate's message of generating the best for where people live, work, and play. And if you need more creativity and originality, look no further. We're going to introduce you to more elevators.
I grew up in South Chicago, immigrant family, 8 kids. One of the challenges we faced was finding healthy and affordable housing, paying utility bills, and just making ends meet day to day. I'm excited to be part of an organization that is supporting these communities and that I can bring my expertise in the private industry to help solve one of the biggest problems of our generation, which is climate change. I love how our teams work every day to find solutions to these problems and make sure those communities most in need are not left behind during the transition to clean energy.
I've really been struck over the years by how passionate Elevate staff is about finding ways to help improve the lives of people and the communities in which they live. I've seen some of my teammates figure out ways to deliver groceries to seniors during the pandemic. Other teammates have figured out how to get emergency water to people who don't have access and get their homes reconnected to water service. And then others have figured out ways to help home-based childcare providers remove lead hazards in their facilities so that children have a safe and healthy place to learn and play.
Elevate Energy, they came in and helped, and they did a lot of work for me. They made it lead free, and they drywall my basement, so I'm just grateful, and I have a lot of gratitude for what they done.
A really tough moment back in May when the news of George Floyd's death happened, and it really rocked the nation. And I think a lot of us were really reckoning with, our past and the current history of racism and systemic oppression. And so I think Elevate, like other organizations, did a good job of bringing that conversation to the forefront, thinking about ways, how can we talk about this more? How can we make sure that not only our work in the community is led by race, but also how does our work within the office, the people who work here, reflect the people in the community, reflect diversity and inclusion?
I started a new journey for Elevate Energy. As we were moving into other communities, new markets, the New Markets Initiative team, and looking at ways we could bring the great work that we did in Chicago and Illinois to other states. 5 years later, we have found success. We're growing the amount of staff that we have in the state of Michigan. We've grown all the way to the West Coast, to Oregon. And we've really shown that we've taken the core of what Elevate does, and that's helping people save energy, helping families, to looking at larger goals, larger ways that we can help society, ways we can help society fight climate change, help society with inequity, creating workforce development programs.
I'm really grateful for all of the great work that we all do day in and day out
to make our city, our state, our country, and our world a better place for all of us.
Elevate Energy brings technical expertise, real-world experience, and a vibrant and intelligent staff that never ceases to amaze. They always advocate for policy items that might be overlooked, like energy efficiency. Every time there's an energy discussion, they weave in racial equity principles and fight for clean, accessible energy for all. The work with the Illinois Solar for All program is invaluable and one place in which they pair their technical expertise with community engagement to overcome access issues to clean solar energy. In an increasingly unpredictable environment, Elevate Energy's innovation and creativity and wonderful staff propel them forward.
We are thrilled to congratulate Elevate Energy on your 20th anniversary. Elevate Energy has been a leader in promoting energy efficiency and green retrofits to those who need it most. Elevate Energy has made an important difference in countless people's lives. Bickerdike is a community-based not-for-profit developer. Through our partnership with Elevate, we have installed green retrofits in more than 400 apartments, including high-efficiency furnaces, roof insulation, low-flow water fixtures, and LED lighting. These improvements have made an important difference in the lives of hundreds of families, lowering utility bills and making their homes more comfortable. We look forward to continue working with Elevate and can't wait to see what the next 20 years will bring.
Our last two changemakers bring their creativity and pure imagination solving systemic inequities. They're both powerful people who work incessantly for the neighborhoods they call home. Tonika Lewis Johnson is a visionary as well as a solution-based artist and photographer. Her project, Folded Maps, brings together citizens who live at corresponding addresses on the north and south sides of Chicago, with miles of disparity in between. She examines how systemic segregation has suppressed her Inglewood community. And after receiving a small grant from the Chicago Community Trust, she's now become an international sensation.
Even just utilizing the map of Chicago and looking at it through a lens of segregation and race and environmental justice, you can see that just the landscape of Chicago situates Black neighborhoods in areas that have remained industrial with factories or the remnants of closed factories. And then when you add on abandoned homes and vacant lots, that's another kind of environmental injustice, because now you're creating these issues that are hazardous.
Olga Bautista is the community planning manager at Alliance for the Great Lakes, and she's dedicated her personal and professional career to improving the lives of her fellow community members. And as one of the lead organizers for the Chicago Southeast Side Coalition to Ban Petcoke, she has forced politicians to address this and other pressing environmental issues.
It took us a long time to realize that we are experts too.
Mm-hmm.
We are experts in our own lived experience. And a lot of the things that have changed policies, you know, that have changed here didn't happen because there was an inspector from the city who saw some red flag. You know, it was moms who were pushing the strollers and taking their kids to school who noticed black soot on windowsills, on sidewalks, in the dog water bowl, in the backyard pool. You know, it was everyday people. We know that a lot of that material is actually very harmful and very toxic. That's how we've been able to flip the script here, is to say my life matters. These policies devalue my life and prioritize industry's bottom line, and that is unacceptable.
Elevate has very clearly articulated its dedication to bringing the benefits of efficiency and renewable energy to those who need it most, and that is what brought me here. I want to lend my expertise and experience to advance our mission. Elevate is a thought leader in this space in so many ways, and I really like the way we are integrating all elements of sustainability, water, energy, climate, affordability, resilience, and more. Integration is the bridge from now to next, and I'm excited to be part of that journey.
Coming at you from my little remote working corner here, where I try to help Elevate move its projects forward in the healthiest and safest way possible. I came to Elevate just about 2 years ago, but wow, have things changed since I've started. I started off just literally as a deer in the headlights, trying to wrap my head around all the amazing work that Elevate was doing to help create a more equitable, efficient, and healthy world. Now we find ourselves in the middle of a global pandemic, and yet Elevate has managed to pivot to face this challenge head on, listening to the community and providing them with the services that they need.
Now we're happy to be a part of your team that's bringing solar energy to communities across Illinois. Some of the industry's best talent has come through your doors, and I'm grateful that you let me hire a few of them away. I'm also so proud that some of the most talented people I've had the opportunity to lead are now part of the Elevate family. The rate of energy transformation is accelerating, and it needs to go even faster if we're going to address a worsening climate crisis. Make sure that all communities are part of the solution, and more importantly, that they benefit from a new energy economy. To Anne and the entire Elevate team, so glad that you're on the case, grateful that you've let me be a part of it, and excited about building a carbon-free and inclusive future with you. Well done, and happy birthday.
Happy 20th birthday, Elevate. Congratulations, and here's to 20 years more.
Well, to Al Musavi and all of the other Elevators and partners, you're inspired creative thinkers, and we thank you so much for your deep commitment, and we applaud your pure imagination. And to our electrifying change makers, it's up to you to pass the mic to the next generation of activists coming up behind you. You're making great progress, and that translates into enduring change. You've seen the depth and breadth of their work. Where we were then, being smarter with energy. Where we are now, assisting the people we serve in new ways due to COVID and changing needs. Next, broadening our reach beyond energy, bringing equity at the core of all of our work. And here's Ann Evans to tell us where we're going next in reshaping the culture of the city and the world for a more equitable and creative future.
Thanks, Steve. We are engineers, we are city planners, we are communicators, and we work with our hands. We create. Everything we do is fueled by pure imagination. You'll see what I mean. Here's a creative look at the song Pure Imagination, arranged by Christine Wack.
Come with me.
You'll hear more of that song at the end of the program. That imagination leads to action, and we urge you to take action now. A word that applies to so much of what we do. I'm back now to share with you our vision for our future as collectively we work to rebuild better together. Our Elevate community has a clear intention, and that's to be innovative partners in the development of a just transition to the clean energy future, which restores environmental justice, increases health, builds equity, generates intergenerational wealth, and combats climate change. As we look forward, we will be focused on the intersectionality of the needs of the communities that we are so grateful to serve. That's why we are refreshing our brand as simply Elevate. This refresh broadens Elevate's focus to include clean energy, clean water, renewables, and new solar technologies, workforce development, healthy homes. You get the point. all the pieces of the puzzle that have to come together to achieve better outcomes and real benefits for people and the planet, while maintaining a very intentional focus on racial equity and inclusion. Elevate 2020 is about clean energy and more. At our core, our work is about helping people. As you heard, we partnered with Bickerdike Redevelopment Corporation to assist residents during the pandemic. This is what some of the people we served said. From Lauren Pitts, "My family appreciates everything that is being done to help one another. Not knowing how you're going to pay for housing and food can really take a toll on a person." From Marshika Jones, "Being a new mother and not knowing when I'll be able to bring in income for me and my family can put a lot of stress on anyone. Because of your generosity, a lot of that stress has been lifted as I'm now able to continue to put a roof over my son's head. I now have hope for the future. Acts of kindness will never go unnoticed." And here are stories from Elevate. Ms. Taylor first came to us in 2018 because her furnace was out and she needed heat. We were happy when she called us last April to get assistance with her grocery deliveries because her granddaughter, an essential worker, could no longer take her to the store. And we were so happy that we were able to provide her with air conditioning this summer when there were 5 straight days of extreme heat. Ms. Taylor is able to age in place in her home, a 2-flat she was able to purchase through her many years of hard work as a healthcare worker. She can provide a safe and healthy home for her grandchildren and pass her wealth on to the next generation. As we look to the future, we see Elevate helping many more people like Ms. Taylor. We are also about making sure that people are getting good work and growing their businesses. Liz Howard of Howard & Sons Construction asked us for help to transform her business online so that she could keep her employees paid and working during COVID. She also made her business more efficient for now and into the future. She's able to do more work more efficiently, and she's seen it hit her bottom line. That's how Elevate helps create racial equity and decrease the racial wealth divide. Elevate amplifies the stories of people we serve, families, businesses, communities, and local government. We know that their needs matter. We share these authentic stories with policymakers who can make broader systemic change so that everyone is able to not only survive, but thrive in an environmentally sustainable and healthy way. Thank you to all of our supporters who helped us then, now, and next. I'm giving you all a well-deserved shout out as I share my gratitude for your partnership. Join me as we work together towards our shared future where everyone has healthy, safe, affordable ways to have heat, power, and clean water in their homes, no matter who they are or where they live. Our work provides people with hope, creates good jobs, and addresses the climate crisis. And our actions create racial equity and decrease the racial wealth divide. Thank you, and let's get to work.
Thanks, Anne. Great words to live by. I'm Sylvia Ewing, Director of Strategic Communication, Marketing, and Outreach at Elevate. I know lots of you out there in the live stream universe and miss seeing you in person. I see Elena and Vito and hi, Yami. Oh, and I have to say hi to my grandkids. Hi, Layla. Hi, Ilias. But let's shift gears for a minute and talk about something that many of us share, a connection to and deep appreciation for Elevate. As you just heard from our community partners and others, people appreciate help, and we are stronger together. Elevate believes in listening to and uploading what people want instead of downloading what we think they need. The entire organization's focus on listening helps us make an impact for positive change. If you're inspired or renewed by our commitment to residents everywhere, we need your help. Text to give now. There are many ways to join us as an ally. Post on social media, tell a friend about us. But what we'd really like you to do today is to join us as a donor in an amount that's meaningful to you. texts to give. Thank you for being here with us today. It means so much to have your fellowship in this moment. Thank you for you've already made a donation. If you have been inspired by what you've seen, if you want us to do more work elevating everything and passing the mic to people like our climate change makers, please do what you can to make a donation right now. Your contribution goes even further thanks to an anonymous donor. Simply text to give and make an ongoing monthly donation of $10, $15, whatever works for you. We are on this journey together. Thank you for the past 20 years. Thank you on behalf of each and every elevator, board member, and our families. We do what we do for our children and yours. Thanks.
And thank you all for joining us for Elevate Together, a reflection of Elevate's first 20 years, and salute to 8 exceptional climate change makers putting their hearts and souls into making their city a better place, neighborhood by neighborhood. The good news is that young people are leading the charge for brighter days. They want a world that's diverse and inclusive, and so do we. Don't forget, great things can happen when you imagine they can and you put in the work. So as promised, here's a send-off from Christine Wack. Thank you for joining us. Stay safe and enjoy.
River wide.